Why can't humans fly like birds? Flying is something birds can do easily, but humans can't. Let's find out why. Different bodies. Birds have lightweight bodies with special wings that help them fly. Humans, on the other hand, have heavier bodies and no wings. No natural wings. Unlike birds, humans don't have wings or feathers. Our arms and hands are designed for different tasks, like grasping and holding things. Stronger muscles. Birds have strong chest muscles that help them flap their wings and stay airborne. While humans have strong muscles too, they're not built for flying. Gravity. Gravity is the force that pulls everything toward the ground. Humans are affected by gravity, making it hard for us to lift off and stay in the air like birds. Flying machines. Unlike birds, humans don't have wings or feathers. Our arms and hands are designed for different tasks, like grasping and holding things. These machines use engines and wings to lift off and soar through the sky. Dreaming of flight. While we may not be able to fly naturally, humans have always dreamed of flying. That's why we've created inventions like hot air balloons, gliders, and even wingsuits for skydiving. Kids, just a friendly reminder, we can't fly like birds because our bodies are different. So, let's stick to what we're good at and stay safe on the ground. And while humans can't fly like birds, we found other ways to experience the thrill of soaring through the air.
Flying high, the science of flight. Flying is like magic, but it's also science. Let's learn some cool things about how airplanes and birds fly. Wings and air. Birds and airplanes have special wings that help them fly. When air flows over their wings, it creates lift, which pushes them up into the sky. Going up. To go up, airplanes and birds tilt their wings upwards. This helps them catch more air and lift higher into the sky. Coming down. When it's time to come down, airplanes and birds tilt their wings downwards. This helps them glide smoothly back to the ground, flapping and soaring. Birds flap their wings to fly, while airplanes use engines and propellers, but both use the same principles of aerodynamics to soar through the air. Flying is a wonderful adventure that shows us how amazing science can be. So let's spread our wings and soar like birds in the sky. Blast off! Make a baking soda and vinegar rocket. Are you ready to launch into a space adventure right in your backyard? Let's make a mini rocket using simple ingredients you can find at home. Here's what you'll need: a film canister with a tight-fitting lid, baking soda, vinegar. Here's how to make your rocket. First, find a safe outdoor space to launch your rocket. Make sure there's plenty of room to run around and watch your rocket soar. Second, open the lid of the film canister and put a small amount of baking soda inside. You don't need too much, just a pinch will do. Third, now pour some vinegar into the film canister. Be careful not to spill any. Fourth, quickly snap the lid onto the film canister and place it upside down on the ground, lid side down. Fifth, stand back and get ready for liftoff. As the vinegar reacts with the baking soda, it creates gas that builds up pressure inside the canister. Soon, your rocket will shoot up into the sky like a real spaceship. It's a simple but exciting way to explore science and learn about chemical reactions. So, gather your materials and get ready to blast off into the cosmos with your homemade rocket.
Zooming with science. Make your own balloon car. Did you know? You can make a cool car that runs on air right at home. Here's how. First, gather your materials. You'll need some cardboard, straws, bottle caps, tape, and a balloon. Second, build your car. Cut out a small rectangle from the cardboard to make the body of your car. Attach the bottle caps to the bottom corners of the cardboard to make wheels. Then, tape the straws onto the sides of the car to make axles for the wheels. Third, add the balloon. tape the opening of the balloon onto the back of the car. Make sure it's sealed tight so no air can escape. Fourth, ready, set, go! Inflate the balloon by blowing air into it, then pinch the opening shut. Place your car on a smooth surface, and when you're ready, let go of the balloon. Watch as the air rushes out of the balloon, propelling your car forward. This simple experiment teaches us about the power of air and how it can be used to make things move. So, grab your materials and get ready to race with your homemade balloon-powered car.